Welcome back to The Buzz. Joining me today is Heather Quick, the CEO of the Quick Law Group. Welcome to The Buzz.
Thank you so much. Happy to be here.
So you are a women-only family law firm. Tell me about the Quick Law Group, when you guys started, and a little bit more about what services you offer females.
I went out on my own about 4 years ago, and we were doing divorce and family law. That had been part of my background. It evolved since I graduated from law school, and we began to evolve to just represent women only because I felt as though the women were underserved generally in this area of law, and that was my passion. So we began to evolve the firm to just represent women in divorce and family law matters.
Where'd you go to law school?
Stetson in St. Petersburg.
And what brought you to Jacksonville?
I'm a native of Jacksonville, third generation actually.
And that's very rare now.
I know it is.
What's your favorite thing about Jacksonville?
The beach.
The beach?
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. So when you started the firm, currently you went on your own, you now have how many attorneys that work within your group?
I have 5 attorneys working with me, for me, and...
Which one's your favorite?
I probably should say Anna, because she'll be mad at me if
what
I don't.
What I do every day, I tell everybody they're my favorite. They've caught on to that now, and nobody believes me anymore.
That's how I work with our children. You know, who's your, yes, you are my favorite. Then the next one asks you, yes, you're my favorite. So absolutely.
How many children do you have?
I have 3.
How old?
13, 10, and 6.
I've got a 5, 3, and 9-month-old. So I'm entering those fun days of constant
yes.
Disney. So are you involved in different organizations in the community right now?
I am involved with the schools, with my children in St. John's County. Within Jacksonville, I was a member of the Mayor's Victims Assistance Council in Jacksonville. I'm also a member of the Jacksonville Bar Association and chair of the Judicial Relations Committee, which I've enjoyed very much.
And you help a lot with the Hubbard House?
Yes, as there's always a call for lawyers to provide pro bono services. And, you know, one of my beliefs was, well, I wanted to continue to be in alignment with what our firm does and help women. So what we've done is we reached out to the Hubbard House, and they were gracious and very excited to have us come to them. That way, for any of their victims, it's a safe environment. We go every other month. One of the attorneys from the firm, we provide education, almost like a legal clinic, answer questions, and really whatever they may need for those women.
What is a typical question when people call you for the first time? What's one of the main questions they always ask?
You know, women are generally very concerned about the finances, as well as the children. But what, and it may be shocking to many, but still in this day and age, there are many relationships where the husband controls the financial aspect, and the women feel as though it's not a good idea.
Probably spend too much,
and it may start as a division of labor. You know, in typical marriages, everybody then has their duties. But what I see more often, and that would be because obviously it becomes a dysfunctional relationship, is then it turns into a complete control issue, and it's a controlling over the woman and the wife, and she's very concerned. Like, I don't know what we have. I know we're doing well, but I don't know where it is, what it is, and if I want to get a divorce, where am I going to get that money? Because he controls it all.
So how do you help in that situation?
We really work with our clients on how they can get themselves situated to at least begin the divorce process. If there are finances there, I mean, it's theirs as well, no matter what the husband tells them. And then through the courts and the judges, they will order the husband to, one, provide support to the wife and children, as well as contribute to the attorney's fees.
What's the hardest thing about your job?
Managing the expectations of the clients. I would say there's the one part of running the business, which is, again, making sure that all my employees and staff have the resources they need, and we plan the strategy, that's really fun for me in helping them strategize for cases. But definitely with clients, you know, they come in with, most of the time, this is their first really interaction with a lawyer. And even, it doesn't matter how sophisticated or how professional the individual is, when it's your own life, it's very different. So we really have to help educate and help them understand what life may look like after this divorce as it relates to the children and finances.
When you're not working, what do you enjoy doing? The beach, obviously, but
I play tennis. And I am, yes.
Right. And I wait for people to say, no, I'm looking for tennis partners that are no good so I can actually have a chance of winning.
And so we live at the beach, and I, you know, was just at a swim meet last night with my children. So we go to the beach, play tennis, I do yoga, and we certainly like to go do trips with the children as well. So,
and your favorite, I guess, favorite place to see a concert in Jacksonville? What was the last either concert or theater show that you saw?
Well, I was at the St. Augustine Amphitheater for the, you know, 80s, reliving the 80s with Salt and Pepper and with a lot of friends. And that was really fun. And that was actually the first time I'd been in that venue, believe it or not. That was great fun. And I love the Veterans Arena. I was there for Pearl Jam. So, you know, showing my age with all these concerts.
Excellent. Is there anything else that you'd like us to know about you or your firm?
Yeah, with our firm, we focus, definitely it's a difficult period for our clients' lives going through a divorce, and it's just, you know, they have to really open up about a lot of personal things that's very uncomfortable for them. But we really strive to make it a good experience for the women going through that. We have over 30 years combined experience with our lawyers, and I feel like we're a little bit outside the box because we really want to know, what do you want to do with your life for our clients? And that helps us plan their legal strategy and move forward. So we are for helping women move forward and beyond the divorce. I'm a big proponent of women entrepreneurs and, you know, educating themselves and getting out there and doing all that they're capable of. Many women, when they're at this period in their life, are at a low point in self-esteem and fear. And so everyone on the team believes that, only, you know, in themselves, but as well as our clients. So we just really look for that ability to lift up our clients.
So everyone other than my wife looking to get a divorce that is a female, please visit online. What is your website?
TheQuickLawGroup.com.
TheQuickLawGroup.com. I tell my wife if she leaves me, I'm going with her because I'll be lost. So happily married, thank God.
Well, and that's good. You know, it's so fun. I have so many, of course, male friends. I'm happily married, and we talk all the time, and they want to know, well, what should I do? And it's like, well, you know, be a partner and help and be open and, you know, make sure you're in it together. And it's hard with kids. I'll tell you, I know it is. You know, people can drift apart and it doesn't happen overnight. It's a long progression. So it's worth working for it because as I've had many clients in multiple different marriages, subsequent marriages, it's not really any different. So if you're in a happy relationship, it's worth keeping it together.
Well, what we'd like to do is donate a $5,000 Buzz ad credit to the Hubbard House in your name to help promote their cause and mission. They do a lot of great work for women, and we want to help you guys continue to help them.
So, well, wonderful. I know they would love that. It's a wonderful organization. You read every day about sexual assault, domestic violence, and it needs to stop and it needs to change. And it starts with just education and awareness and empowering women, but also educating men and to notice when it's going on. So that'll be wonderful. I know they'll be very happy.
Well, thanks for joining us today, and we will see you next time on The Buzz.